गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम निवास कुमार, योर साइंस टीचर। टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज केमिकल इफेक्ट्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करेंट। दिस इज द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर ऑल्सो। वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस चैप्टर 14, केमिकल इफेक्ट्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करेंट, क्लास 8 साइंस। सो हियर वी विल सी दैट व्हेन इलेक्ट्रिक करेंट इज पास्ड through a chemical substance, that means through a conducting liquid or through a conducting solution, then what effects are produced? We know that when electric current is passed through a conductor, then three types of effects can be produced. They are known as heating effect of electric current, magnetic effect of electric current, and third one is chemical effects of electric current. Basically, in this video, our main purpose is to discuss about the chemical effects of electric current. Before discussing regarding the topic, let us try to understand some terms. Here you can see the diagram. This one is battery, this is anode and this is cathode. They are known as electrodes. So here we shall understand what are electrodes. Second one, conducting solution, which is known as electrolyte. And third one, a process known as electrolysis. So first of all, we understand electrodes, electrolyte and electrolysis. So electrode means basically these are the carbon rods, graphite rods or the metal rods. Why? Because carbon rods or graphite rods are the good conductor of electricity. These are the carbon rods or graphite rods or the metal rods which are dipped partially into the solution and its top are connected with the positive and negative terminals of the battery. So electrode means the graphite rods or the metal rods which are dipped partially into the solution and whose tops are connected with the terminals of battery are known as electrodes. There are two types of electrodes. One is known as anode, other is known as cathode. Anode, here you can see that this anode, this graphite rod which is known as anode, it is connected with the positive terminal of the battery and this is connected with the negative terminal of the battery. So anode is connected with the positive terminal of the battery and cathode is connected with the negative terminal of the battery. So the electrode which is connected with the positive terminal of the battery is known as anode, whereas the electrode which is connected with the negative terminal of the battery is known as cathode. So these two terms, anode and cathode, are clear. Next one is electrolyte. Electrolyte means the conducting solution. The solution which conducts electricity is known as electrolyte. And third one, electrolysis. Electrolysis means the decomposition of a substance into positive and negative ions when electric current is passed through it is known as electrolysis. Electrolysis is the name of a process in which a substance splits, breakdowns when electric current is passed through it. So these are the three terms. Now let us understand about chemical effects of electric current. Chemical effect of electric current means when electric current is passed through a conducting solution, then chemical reaction takes place in the solution. As a result, following effects can be seen. First, formation of gas on the electrodes. Second, deposition of metal on the electrode. Which electrode? Cathode. Third one is color of the solution may change. So these are the three facts. When electric current is passed through a conducting solution, then three facts are produced. First, formation of gas. Formation of gas. Gas will form and it will deposit on anode and on cathodes. That means on these two electrodes. Second, deposition of metal. Metal is always deposited on the cathode. This is known as, this process is also known as electroplating. This is done to prevent the process of rusting. Suppose that iron metal, we have iron metal. We know that iron metal is very strong, but it gets rusted whenever it is left in open air. So to prevent the process of rusting, if we deposit a metal like chromium, zinc, etc., then this coating of chromium and zinc will prevent the iron from rusting. So this is a very useful process, deposition of metal on electrode. It always occurs on cathode. And third one, this color of the solution. Color of the solution may change. So these effects are known as chemical effects of electric current. Now let us see how gases are formed. Gases are formed when electric current is passed through a conducting solution. Let us see it in the process of electrolysis of water. Electrolysis of water. Electrolysis means, electro means electricity and lysis means breakdown. So what is the meaning of electrolysis? The meaning of electrolysis is the breakdown of a substance by means of electricity. That means when electricity will pass through a substance through a conducting solution, it will split, it will decompose and forms two substances. So the decomposition of a substance, the breakdowns of a substance on passing electricity through it is known as electrolysis. Since we are going to discuss about electrolysis of water, that means here electric current will pass through water and then water molecule will decompose and it will form hydrogen and oxygen gases. So electrolysis of water means when electric current is passed through water, then it decomposes and forms hydrogen and oxygen gases. This process is called electrolysis of water. The first of all, it was a British chemist known as William Nicholson. He performed this experiment in 18th century. So the electrolysis of water was discovered by William Nicholson. This is the diagram of the electrolysis of water. With the help of the diagram, we try to understand what actually happens. So here, this is a plastic container. This one is a plastic container having two holes at the bottom. Two graphite rods are fixed in these two holes and it is connected. These graphite rods are connected with the two terminals of battery. This graphite rod is connected with the positive terminal of the battery, so it is known as an anode. It becomes anode, and this rod is connected with negative terminal of the battery, so this forms a cathode. So before connecting these two rods with the terminals of battery, first of all, we fill the container with water. We know that water is a poor conductor of electricity, and therefore to make it more conducting, we add some acids, few drops of acid. Let me add sulfuric acid. You can add few drops of hydrochloric acid also, just to make the water more conducting. Now, after that, you take two similar test tubes. These are the test tubes filled with water, and then you place these two test tubes over these two electrodes. Over these two electrodes in inverted position. Now, when electricity is passed, after connecting these two rods anode and cathode with the battery, with the positive and the negative terminals of the battery, then electric current will pass. When electric current will pass through the water, then we see that the water decomposes into hydrogen and hydroxide ion. When electric current is passed through water, then water molecule dissociates into hydrogen and hydroxide ion, S plus and OH minus ion. We know that opposite charges attract each other. Since anode, it is connected with the positive terminal of the battery, so it behaves with the positive terminal, it is a positive terminal. Cathode is connected with the negative terminal of the battery, so it is the negative, it behaves with the negative terminal. And that's why the S plus, water molecule will dissociate and form H plus and OH minus ion. So positive charge will attract toward the negative electrode, that means what cathode. In this electrode and negative ion, that is hydroxide ion, get attracted toward anode. And therefore, the hydrogen gas is formed in cathode, and oxygen gas is formed in anode. In this way, these two types of gases are collected into different electrodes. So, when electricity or electric current is passed through water, then water molecule dissociates into H plus and OH minus ion. Due to the H plus ion, hydrogen gas is formed. Hydrogen gas is liberated in cathode, and due to OH minus ion, oxygen gas is formed and it is liberated in anode. So in this way, we see that in electrolysis of water, two gases are formed. So this is one of the chemical effect of electric current, formation of gas. Now, in next video, we will see about the deposition of metal on cathode. Thank you.